Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. If you're new, welcome. My name is Donna. If you are a returning visitor or subscriber, I just want to thank you very much for joining me here to talk about this very special evening on Friday. So if you're in Europe, the partial eclipse is 27 degrees in Taurus, and it will take place at 9:04 GMT or Universal Time, which is Central Time in Europe. If you're in the U.S., the eclipse will take place at 3:04 a.m. Central Time, and it is going to be the longest lasting eclipse in recorded history since 1440. Yes, you heard me right, 1440. It will feel, because the eclipse is so long, that you're in a state of suspended animation. So I would advise anyone to allow extra time in their day for this eclipse to complete, because it's going to really seem that things are frozen or just stagnant, but they aren't. A lot is happening right now. The focus on the eclipse is between Taurus, what you desire, and Scorpio, that which needs to die and go away for you to have what you want. So this is a two-year eclipse season on the Scorpio-Taurus axis, and it really lasts until October 28th of 2023. It is a time when you will be urged by the universe to rid yourself of everything that does not serve your life right now. You are not going to have time for a lot of frivolous interaction if you want to get to your goal. So it really is important to remember that if you are unwilling to make changes of any sort that are in your best interest, eclipse seasons will have the ability to do it for you. So what does that mean, Donna? It means that you could be engaged to someone, and you might have a wonderful job that you love in a community, or you know, something that you just would never want to leave, and all of a sudden this partner that you love but isn't really right for you gets a job offer in another country, and you really can't go and maintain your current job. So that is just a very strong example of what can happen and the way the universe can take people out of your life, even when you are holding on to them. So toxic relationships are not going to fly in the next 2 years. Everybody is going to really be forced and coaxed into alignment with your higher good. It is time to form a two-year plan for yourself so that you can reach your most cherished goals. And as your goals unfold, you know, your roadmap will change. You'll make deviations and edits to it to take into account things that are changing on an ongoing basis. So that's to be expected. But it is really important that you really focus on that which is more the most authentic. What are you? Who are you? Spirit and the universe are really pushing you very forcefully at this time, in the next 2 years, to really be clear about what you want. If you can't be clear about it, if you can't envision what that looks like, you can't really manifest it. So it's the universe is going to assist you in helping you make those discoveries. This is a time of dramatic improvements that allow you to get what you want by slowing down on the activities that don't serve you or the relationships that don't serve you. So, you know, if you're playing poker on Wednesday night with, you know, people that you don't even enjoy, you really wonder why you're doing it. You're just going to eliminate the activity. It really is that simple. So the eclipse has an overall very positive energy. There are a lot of great aspects on Friday that are very important to watch and to enjoy. The energy favors at this time decisions about contracts and loans, investments, and serious health improvements. It's a good time to make those decisions and to focus on those areas of your life. creative potential is going to spring out of your dreams, out of your urges to listen to haunting music. Oddly enough, with all this energy in Pisces right now, it will be a time when you'll be have an urge to dance, to listen to great music, or to create something in the performance industry for many of you. For some of you, that will be a hobby. For others of you, professionally, you can follow your dreams and have great success in that area. Dream big. Dare to dream big right now. Go big or go home, as they say. We see that beautifying your workspace is going to really help right now because it's going to make you have a more zen feeling. So you don't feel anxiety. You know, you're eliminating all of that energy that makes you anxious about going to the desk, so to speak. So it's clearing the clutter, putting a bouquet of flowers down, hanging a nice picture, making that space very sacred and very happy for you when you're in the energy of work. You may fall in love with a very eccentric person right now. You could fall in love with a very unusual form of art. Things that are eccentric are very appealing, and your abundance may increase very unexpectedly at times. You will have many more romantic opportunities coming in the next 2 years, so choose carefully. Oddly enough, well, not so oddly enough, because it is a Taurus energy, and Taurus is the Hierophant card. You know, it's the card of Venus, which is the Empress, and it's all about traditional beliefs. And it's very interesting energy right now because you may be dating somebody who's very conservative or like-minded in terms of traditional beliefs and values. And the funny thing is that it seems almost odd that that person may have, you may form an intense physical, sexual bond. The lovemaking may be off the charts, and it's going to be with someone who is very strongly Scorpio or Taurus in their charts, but it is also an energy in your relationship that's going to bring about a lot of healing. Being on the same page with somebody, feeling safe and secure in the area of intimacy is going to be paramount. It's incredibly important. You know that song, Sexual Healing with Barry White? It's going to be a time in your life when you're going to thank your lucky stars. You're going to be so happy that you met this person. And they're going to seem like the librarian, you know, the sexy librarian, all buttoned down, hair in a chignon, you know, a French twist. And then all of a sudden you take one pen out and the music comes on. So it is really a favorable time in your life right now for the right romance, for pursuing the right activities that support your long-term goals. You may find a lover because of the strong Pisces energy that's so favorable right now. You could find a deep relationship with a lover in a ballroom dance class or in a music venue or in some very expressive creative class or activity of any sort. So keep your eyes out for that. It's a kind of a very special, magical kind of energy. We do want you to really take into account that there are some very intense energies that are that we need to caution you about, or I need to caution you about. But it really is watching out, being overly optimistic right now, and speaking without knowing facts can make you appear foolish. We're at a point in time right now where you need to take time to think and negotiate well if you have a contract coming up. But it would be preferable if you wait for a week or so before you do that. But if you need to, just be very smart. Don't be frivolous. Be very focused on what you're doing. It might be something that makes you very happy. You could be buying a home, but and you might be very joyful and exuberant, but when it comes time to sign the contract, be very focused like a student in a legal class, you know, a law class. Tempers and impulsiveness are at a peak right now astrologically. it is a time when accidents could occur, and they could be very bad accidents. So we really want you to be safe and sound. Unintentional risks where, you know, you might get mad and you might, you know, hit the gas, or you might get a little bit, you might be looking at your phone and you might just look down and find yourself in, you know, an accident or a fender bender. But it is a time that you need to be very focused on your safety. You know, don't drive fast very much. You know, and don't take risks right now. Don't gamble with your finances or even your anger. You know, just don't pop off. This would be a time that you could virtually end a very significant relationship, even a job, if you just mouth off and it hits the wrong person at the wrong time. So in anger, you know, watch your anger in word and deed until next week, because right now the negative impact would be very much amplified. So that is your lunar forecast for Friday, the 19th of November. And I want to thank you for sharing this energy with me and being with me today. Please comment below and tell me where you're watching the video from. Are you in Europe? Where around the globe are you? I'm broadcasting from Chicago, and I'm going to send you love. Take care. Donna Wilder-Hart signing out. Love and light from Chicago. Take care. Bye-bye.